Biden tomorrow night, yeah, I get a little bit of tune in. So my sources, and I hate to use anonymous sources, but I have to here, say that he's rehearsing all day today on the teleprompter. They want to do the interview live. They're not sure whether they can, because in the initial rehearsals that Joe Biden is doing, they had a little trouble. Now, specifically, I don't know what the trouble is, whether he's having trouble with the words, reading the prompter, he's not being authoritative enough. I don't know. But I do believe it will be a live presentation at 10 on Thursday night. I'll have analysis right after that on BillO'Reilly.com for you. But there is some concern, I think that's a fair word, inside the Biden camp about the former vice president delivering this address, because it's important for him to do so. All right, so I'm going to run you two sound bites from last night, and these are the most amusing. I'm just doing this because I want to be amused. I'm not doing it for news purposes because there's no news value in this, but they're amusing. First, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, go.
In fidelity and gratitude to a mass people's movement working to establish 21st century social, economic, and human rights, including guaranteed health care, higher education, living wages, and labor rights for all people in the United States. A movement striving to recognize and repair the wounds of racial injustice, colonization, misogyny, and homophobia, and to propose and build reimagined systems of immigration and foreign policy that turn away from the violence and xenophobia of our past. A movement that realizes the unsustainable brutality of an economy that rewards explosive inequalities of wealth for the few at the expense of long-term stability for the many.
All right, so the Congresswoman did not mention Joe Biden in her speech. What she did mention is communism. She's a communist, not a socialist. She's a communist. Let me give you the definition. This is from the Encyclopedia Britannica, quote, political and economic doctrine that aims to replace private property and profit-based economy with public ownership and communal control of at least a major means of production and natural resources of a society, unquote. So, I mean, all you have to do is listen to this. The economy is brutal. We have to do away with the explosive inequality. She's a communist. Karl Marx could have given this. Joseph Stalin, Mao Zedong, all of them. This is exactly what they said. All right? We got to get rid of the czar because he's corrupt and he's violent. We got to get rid of Chiang Kai-shek because he's a violent guy. Same thing. And she was reading on a teleprompter. But no Biden. Okay. Now we'll go from one extreme to the other. You ready? Colin Powell. Now, Colin Powell is a liberal Democrat. Yes, he served as Secretary of State under George W. Bush, who, in Powell's mind, betrayed him because Powell was the weapons of mass destruction point man. And it turned out there were no weapons of mass destruction inside Iraq. And Powell never, never forgave President Bush or the Republican establishment for that. So he's a Democrat now, but he still says he's a Republican. Roll the tape.
Today, we are a country divided, and we have a president doing everything in his power to make it that way and keep us that way. What a difference it will make to have a president who unites us, who restores our strength and our soul.
Well, General, my soul's right here. I mean, I don't need it restored. I'm fine with the soul aspect of the analysis. And as we went over yesterday, there's no way Joe Biden's uniting anybody. All right, with his, you know, intensely left programs. I mean, there's no way that moderate conservative Republicans are ever going to say, yeah, no, that Joe, you've got a point. Not going to happen. So why spout it, General? You know it's not going to happen. Kasich knows it's not going to happen. Why bother? Just say, I don't like Trump. I think Trump's an idiot. I think he's incompetent. I'm voting for Biden. That's all. Don't give me this. He's going to bring us together business. This is all a bunch of garbage. And that's why nobody watches.
Bill O'Reilly is back on TV and only on the 1st. No Spin News, every weeknight at 8 p.m. Eastern, only on the 1st.